Hello, in this video we're going to look at how we can represent characters in binary. So every single piece of data used by a computer has to be stored in binary. And so that includes characters. We can see characters on your screen right now. How are these being stored in the computer? Well, just to be really clear what a character is, a character is a letter, number, or symbol. And also there are some special control characters as well. In programming we have strings. Strings are multiple characters in a sequence. So, long story short, to be able to store characters in binary, we need to give each character a unique character code. And this character code is often written as a deanery number, but in reality, we store it in binary. It needs to be unique so that the code for capital A is different to the code for capital B. What exactly this code is doesn't really matter as long as it is unique. I could just decide, oh, I want to store capital A as 1 in binary. I might decide to store 4 bits for each character code. I can just decide this. There is no definitive way to assign characters to character codes. Some human just decides, oh, A is 1. For 1 in deanery or binary is what we call the character code. So we have multiple characters in alphabets. We need to use multiple characters. The collection, the group of all of these character codes is the character set. So your computer will have at least one character set installed, which has all of the characters it can support and their corresponding character codes. So in my made up character set, I might assign B to be 2, C to be 3, D to be 4, and so on. The character set just needs to be clear what characters it supports and also what their corresponding unique codes are. So I could create my own character set if I wanted to, but it won't really take off because there are already two big character sets in operation which we use nowadays. ASCII is our first one. So ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. And it's been a character set used since the 1960s, so a long time. It being American is relevant for some of its properties, but also I've underlined standard because we use the word standard in the networking topic, often with protocols. It's a standard because ASCII is widely agreed upon and it is really a set of rules. So it's also another example of a standard beyond protocols. This character set has binary codes that are each 8 bits. So for every character, it has a unique 8-bit binary code. In other words, each character code is 1 byte. Now this means it can represent at most 256 characters. Now why is that the case? Where has that number come from? Well, that number has come from the number of combinations. So in other words, in 8 bits, I can have 256 unique combinations. And mathematically, we get to this second number by doing 2 to the power 8. So this tells us how many combinations binary is going to have with 8 bits. 2 to the power 8 is 256. And this formula you'll recognize if you watch my binary shifts video. We always have 2 as our base because it is binary. We've got 2 digits, 0 and 1. And our power is how many bits we have. And in this case, it gives us how many combinations we can get with 8 bits. This little formula is really important for future topics like images and sound as well. Now ASCII is a character set. It is just a massive table containing all the characters it supports. So we've got 256 characters to play with. People who created ASCII just decided what characters to fit into 256. So here are some real ASCII codes. In the exam, you might be shown snippets of ASCII tables like this. You don't have to memorize any codes. They'll give you the code that you need to use. You can see here that capital A isn't 1 like in my made up character set. Capital A in ASCII is 65 in deanery, which is the equivalent of this in binary. And we can see here something really quite important. I've got capital letters A, B, and Z. I've skipped out of the middle bit of my alphabet. A, B, and Z, 65 to 90. We've also got lowercase a, lowercase b, and lowercase z, and all the other lowercase letters between 97 and 122. So the lowercase and uppercase letters are stored separately in ASCII. They've got different ASCII codes. This is why in programming, if you were to compare capital A to lowercase a, that would give you false because they are stored differently in binary. They are different characters as far as the computer is concerned. We also, to point out, have what we call control characters. So these are not really worth knowing too much about, but there are some of these 256 characters used up by fairly boring control characters, like things like the escape key and markers for end of text. We also have our symbols. I'm just showing you 2 of them here. The symbols on your keyboard would be also in ASCII with their own unique codes. And we also have numbers as well. So numbers can be stored as characters, of course. Again, in Python, if I was to go something like 1 as a character is equal to 1 as an integer, that would give us false because again, the one as an integer is stored differently to the one as a character. You can see one as a number is actually stored as if it was 49 in ASCII. It's a little bit confusing, but essentially the ASCII numbers are treated differently to their integer or float equivalents. And just another couple of things to point out, we can see the ASCII codes are what we call sequential. So the code for capital A is 65, the code for capital B is 66, and the code for capital C therefore would be 67. So commonly they'll give you one of the codes, like A, and ask you to work out the code for D based on this. And again, you just use the properties of the alphabet and you use the fact that they are sequential, they are in order, to work out what future codes will be. And the last thing I'll point out is we also have a space character, which I couldn't really show on the table because it is just a space, but space is a character. Every space I've got on the slide here is being stored in ASCII in my computer. It is still a character. It's just invisible to us to see. Now ASCII, one of the earlier character sets, has been replaced now with Unicode. So Unicode is another character set which tries to fix a fairly big problem with ASCII, which is that ASCII was only ever able to represent English characters. So 256 characters just isn't sufficient to fit in other languages like Arabic and Cyrillic and Hindi, which have whole different characters to the English letters. And there just wasn't space in ASCII's 256 characters to store these other languages. Unicode was needed to support basically all the languages we need in the world. This is really important for compatibility. Compatibility is the ability for multiple devices to work together smoothly. If we had one person using ASCII and another person in another country using a whole different character set, they would not be able to communicate in any easy way. However, if every computer is using Unicode, it means they can communicate. It means text can show up consistently across all computers. So Unicode is more complicated than ASCII. ASCII always uses 8 bits per character. Unicode has a variable length of character codes. They are between 8 bits, so at a minimum, it's the same as ASCII, up to 32 bits per character. Now, that might not seem like a big improvement, but a common version of Unicode uses 16 bits per character. 2 to the power of 16 is around 65,000 characters. That more than covers most, well, all major languages and things like emojis as well. But 2 to the power of 32 is even more extreme, really, it's sort of overkill. This supports around 4 billion characters. So it can cover things like extinct languages and stuff like that. A downside of using more bits per character is it takes up more storage space. That's why it gives you the choice to use 8 bits, 16 bits, or 32 bits to try and save storage space if you don't need all of these other languages. Now, the last important fact to know about Unicode is ASCII is part of Unicode. So therefore, really they are interchangeable. It means the character codes for the English letters are the same in both ASCII and Unicode. So the code for capital A in ASCII is 65 in Deanery. It will also be 65 in Unicode. And occasionally exam questions will test you on that fact by asking you what is the Unicode equivalent, but it'll be the same if it is an English character.